The New York Times calls it a brazen two-year insider trading scheme between once golf buddy Scott London, a senior executive at the accounting giant KBMG, and Brian Shaw, a jeweler in the Los Angeles area. London routinely gave Shaw secret information about KPMG's clients, and Shaw traded on the tips, earning more than $1 million in illegal profits from 2010 to 2013.
When you deal with large amounts of money, you obviously think that you're above the law, you're something special. And when you think you're above the law or something special, you take your chances. Figuring, again, if you get caught, if the worst comes to worst, I'll just simply pay these people off. When you've got access to that kind of money, you know, billions of a hundred or even hundreds of billions, you do things that you wouldn't normally do.
The two men netted $1.3 million, a relatively small stake in the world of Wall Street, which even led to London to believe that authorities weren't interested in, quote, small fish like them. Shaw would show his appreciation in various forms. There were envelopes of $100 bills wrapped in $10,000 bundles. There were expensive tickets to rock concerts and even a $12,000 Rolex watch. But earlier this year, Shaw turned against London after investigators confronted him with evidence of insider trading. He became a government informant, recording telephone conversation and in-person meetings to help the authorities build a case against London. London's lawyer told a judge on Thursday that London would plead guilty at a hearing set for May 17th. If convicted, he could face a maximum penalty of 5 years in prison and a fine of $250,000, or twice the gross gain or loss from the alleged insider trading scheme.
Often in white-collar crimes, it's not that unusual for light sentences to be given, if any at all, simply because there's normally an enormous monetary fine to be paid. So unfortunately, a guy who steals, let's say, $300 or $400 million or $500 million, he pays it back with interest, is likely to get off in very, very little prison time. The fact of the matter is, when you've got money, you can buy yourself a lighter jail sentence.
Scott London leaked confidential information on five companies, putting KPMG in hot waters with its partners. The case is the latest in a series of insider trading schemes that have surfaced in the last year or so. It's yet to be seen whether scrutiny on the part of regulators will become mainstream. Susan Medeiros, Press TV, New York.